So next question, friends. 6 coins are tossed. Find the probability of getting at least 2 heads and at least 2 tails. Here he is asking and here at least 4 heads or at most 1 head. So this case is different, friends. Okay, fine. Let us see each case individually. So first, 6 coins are tossed, right? So heads, tails will come, right? So 6C0, 6C1, 6C2, 6C3, 6C4, 6C5, 6C6. Right? If it is 6C0, this is 6C6, this is 6C5, this is 6C4, and this is 6C3, and this is 6C2, and this is 6C1, and this is 6C0. Right or not? So now let us calculate. 6C0 is nothing but 1, 6C1 is 6. So 1 and 6, fine. What is 6C2? In a sense, 6 into 5 divided by 2 into 1. 2, 3 are 6, 3, 5 is 15. And this value is also 15. And 6C3, 6 into 5 into 4 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. This is nothing but 5, 4 is 20. This value is 20. So what is the sample space, friends? Yeah. So 20 plus 30 is nothing but 50. 50 plus 14, 64. It's nothing but 64 is the sample space. Right or not? Now 64 is the sample space, friends. Now, first question is at least 2 heads and at least 2 tails, right? So, what we are going to do? He has asked both at least. At least in the sense greater than or equal to. So, at least in the sense greater than or equal to 2 heads. At least greater than or equal to 2 heads. Right, fine. And at least 2 tails. At least 2 tails in the sense these. Right or not? From 2 to 6, 2 tails. Now, what is the, he has asked, and means intersection, right? So, this is the common part, 15, 20 and 15. So, 20 plus 30 is nothing but 50, right? So, this one is 50 divided by 64. That value is 25 by 32. Right, friends? 25 by 32. Right? So, this is the probability. Now, he has asked at least 4 tails or at most 1 head. See, he has asked the probability of at least 4 tails or means union, at most 1 head, right? So A union B, P of A union B, in the sense we have to use addition theorem. So P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B, yes or no? So P of at least 4 tails plus P of at most 1 head minus P of at least 4 tails intersection at most 1 head. Yes or no? So in this case we need to proceed further. So let us see how to solve. See, friends. So probability of at least 4 tails. What is at least 4 tails, friends? At least tails he is asking. So here at least 4 tails in a sense these 3. Right? So 6 plus 1 is 7. 7 plus 15 is 22. 22 by 64. 22 by 64. Plus at most 1 head in the sense less than or equal to 1 head. So these 2, right? So 6 plus 1 7, 7 by 64 minus, now we have seen the intersection means common term we have to select. So at least 4 tails in the sense, at least 4 tails in the sense, at least is greater than or equal to these 4, fine. At most 1 head in the sense, less than or equal to 1 head, that is nothing but these 2, right? What is the common part intersection here? These 2 common part is nothing but these 2, nothing but 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 by 64 again. So, what is the final value, friends? These 2 will get cancelled. So, 22 divided by 64 is nothing but 11 by 32 is the obtained probability. So, first thing is, whenever or is given, you have to apply the addition theorem and you have to proceed further like this. Fine? So, next question. Okay, friends. Now, let us see a beautiful question. These are all gate questions, friends. Previous year questions. I am not mentioning the name, but the year. But these concepts are very important. See, friends. Two dice are rolled 2 times. Okay. Two dice are rolled 2 times. Find the probability for getting a sum 9. Okay, fine. So, let us see. The die is rolled 2 times. That means experiment is done and 2 events are happened. So, let us say that is event A and event B. 2 times, right? So, 2 events. So, when 2 dice are rolled, sum A will be 9, only these cases, right? So, whenever a die rolled 2 times, 6 square is the output. So, 36 is the total sample space. Yes or no? 36. So now when 9 comes, when 4 comma 5 appears or 5 comma 4 appears, when 3 comma 6 appears or 6 comma 3 appears, yes or no? Yes. So these are the 4 favorable outcomes out of 36 outcomes. So what is the probability in the first event when 9 comes? That is P of A is nothing but 4 by 36. 4 favorable outcomes are there out of 36. So 1 by 9. Then what is P of A complement? 1 minus 1 by 9, right? That is nothing but 8 by 9. So in the second event also some 9 should come. So P of B is also equal to again 4 by 36. That is nothing but 1 by 9. And P of B complement is equal to 1 minus 1 by 9. That is nothing but 8 by 9. Right? So what he has asked now, first one, at least once. I have already told the important formulas of the probability, right? In that formulas, what I have told, at least or either or comes, you have to use a formula. That is nothing but P of A union B. Yes or no? So first one. For this, we have to use P of A union B. Yes or no? So, first one, what is P of A union B, friends? It's nothing but P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B, right? Yes or no? Is this the formula P of A union B? This is nothing but from addition theorem. So, here, see. Fine. What is P of A intersection B, friends? Here, when we can, here before we need to understand P of A intersection B, first of all, we have to understand what type of event it is. The die is rolled 2 times. That means each are having separate sample space and separate trails, right? First event having separate trail, second is having separate trail. Both are independent events. Yes or no? In independent events, P of A intersection B is nothing but product of 2 particular events for P of A into P of B. So since the experiment is done independently, so P of A plus P of B minus P of A into P of B, right? So what is P of A, friends? 1 by 9. 1 by 9 plus what is P of B? Once again 1 by 9 minus 1 by 9 into 1 by 9. That is nothing but 2 by 9 minus 1 by 81. That is nothing but 18. 9 9s are 80. So what is the LCM, friends? So can I write this 9 into 9? So 9 2s are 18 by 81 minus 1 by 81. That is nothing but 17 by 81. This is the probability of at least once. Fine. Now second one. What is the second one he has asked? Only once he has asked. Only once in the sense, what do you mean by only once? It's nothing but exactly once, right? That is P of A delta B. What do you mean by A delta B, friends? P of A delta B in the sense, P of A complement intersection B plus P of A intersection B complement. Yes or no? Yes. Now, since the intersections are there, we have to multiply the particular 2 events. So, P of A complement into P of B plus P of A into P of B complement. Yes or no? Now, find out the values. What is P of A complement? Here, 8 by 9 is there. Into what is P of B? It's 1 by 9 plus what is P of A? It's 1 by 9 again. And what is P of B complement? It's 8 by 9. So 8 by 81 plus 8 by 81, that is nothing but 16 by 81, right? 16 by 81 is the answer. Next one, twice he is asking. So find the probability of getting some 9 twice. In both times we need some 9. So what is the meaning of twice? Twice is nothing but 2 times. Probability of 2 times in the sense, here also 9 should be there. In this event, here also some 9 should be there. That is nothing but, there should be an intersection should be there. That is nothing but P of A intersection B. A common point should be there. So A intersection B. What is P of A intersection B, friends? Simple. Since the event is independent, P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. Right? What is P of A? 1 by 9. And what is P of B? It's also 1 by 9. So 1 by 81. So next one, fourth one, finally, utmost ones. What is the formula for utmost ones, friends? I have already told that utmost ones in the sense 1 minus P of A intersection B. Yes or no? So 1 minus, what is A intersection B again? P of A into P of B, since it is both events are independent. So 1 minus, what is P of A? 1 by 9, and it's 1 by 9. That is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 81, 80 by 81. So in this way, we have to apply the important formulas what we have discussed earlier with respect to questions. So understand them carefully. Basing on these words, friends, we have to use our mind that, so which formula we have to use, which formula we have to apply, which formula we have not to apply. So you should understand basing on these words. Okay, before that you have to from the given data you have to obtain these 2 probabilities. Okay, hope you understand. So let us see another important question, friends. This is a very good model. Okay, see, two dice are rolled, find the probability. So fine, two dice are rolled means six outputs, two dice, so 36 total outcomes will be there, right or not? So what he is asking, find the probability that neither sum 7 nor sum 11, sum 7 should never come and sum 11 should never come. That is the probability that we need. So first thing, so what, when two dice are rolled, what is the summation? Whenever sum come, 7 comes, when sum 7 will come? Whenever 1 comma 6 happens, 2 6 comma 1 happens, or 2 comma 5 happens, or 5 comma 2 happens, 3 comma 4 happens, or 4 comma 3 happens, right? So these are the possibilities. When sum 11 will come? Only when 5 comma 6 happens or 6 comma 5 happens, that's all, right? So fine. So what now he is asking, neither sum 7 nor sum 11 he is asking. That means probability of neither sum 7, neither means complement, nor in the sense not R. See, there are only R and is there. R means union and means intersection. Nor in the sense not R. Not R means and only, no. Right or not? So and means intersection, sum 11. Yes, 11 complement. Yes or no? So what is this formula, friends? P of A complement intersection B complement. What is the formula? P of 1 minus P of A union B. In the sense, 1 minus P of S7 union S11. In the sense, now we have to use addition theorem here. 1 minus P of S7 plus P of S11 minus P of S7 intersection S11. Yes or no? Now, what is the probability of getting sum 7, friends? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of 36, 6 possibilities are there. So, 1 minus 6 by 36 plus. What is the probability of getting sum 11? Out of 36, we have only 2 possibilities. 2 by 36 minus. So, before getting this intersection value, we need to understand what is the experiment that was done. So, what he is telling, 2 dice are rolled. When 2 dice are rolled, this type of trial and this type of trial are both are independent to each other. No, not independent. Here, look at this. These two are disjoint even, friends. Because, is there any combination, is there any ordered pair common to this? So, 5 comma 6 is not there. 6 comma 5 is not there. These two are mutually exclusive. Yes or no? When mutually exclusive comes, intersection is nothing but 0, right? Yes, these two are disjoint events. So now, 1 minus 6 plus 2 is 8 by 36 is nothing but 36 minus 8 divided by 36. What is 36 minus 8, friends? I think it's 24, right? Yeah, I think it is 36 minus 8 is 28. Yeah, 28 divided by 36. In the sense, 2 ones, 2 fours, 2 18s are 36, next 2 7s 14, 2 9s are 18, 7 by 9 is the answer. So for this question, 7 by 9 is the probability. Fine? Understand? So applying the addition theorem is very important, and just remember that this event is mutually exclusive event. This is not independent because both belongs to same trial. Now let us think about neither product 12 nor product 15. So fine. So whenever product 5 comes, what are the possibilities of product 5? Product 12, right? Yeah, product 12. So 3 comma 4, 4 comma 3, 2 comma 6, 6 comma 2. So these are the product 12 possibilities. Yes or no? Next. What are the product 15 possibilities? 3 comma 5 and 5 comma 3. Yes. Out of 6 comma and 1 comma 1 to 6 comma 6, these are the, out of 36, these are the possibilities. Okay, fine. Neither product 12 nor product 15. Same way, probability of neither product 12 nor product 15. Yes or no? So what is the formula now? 1 minus P of P12 union P15. Again, we have to perform addition theorem. See, friends, 1 minus P of P12 plus P of P15 minus P of P12 intersection P15. See, again, this is in same trial. In one trial only we are applying both the dice. That means we have to check this. So 3 comma 4, 4 comma 3, 2 comma 6 and 6 comma 2. Is there any ordered pair similar to here? No. These two are disjoint events. Hence this value becomes 0. So 1 minus, in disjoint event, A intersection B is 0, right? Probability of A intersection B. So 1 minus, what is P of 12? Probability of getting 12 is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 4 out of 36 plus. What is P of 15? 2 events. So 2 out of 36. This is already 0. That is nothing but 1 minus 6 by 36. So 30 by 36 is nothing but 6 5 is 30, 6 6 are 36. So 5 by 6 is the answer for this question. 5 by 6. So this is very important. Here there is no combination in there is no intersection in P12 and P15. Both are different. Hence P of P12 intersection P15 is 0. So now friends, see, now see the third question. Neither sum 6 nor product 15. In the sense, sum 6 in the sense, what are the possibilities friends? Sum should be 6. So 3, 3, 4, 2, 2, 4, 1, sum 6, right? So 1, 5, 5, 1. Yes or no? Sum should be 3 plus 3, 6, like that. Okay, fine. Now what is product 15? Product 5. So when product 5 will come, 1, 5 comes and 5, 1 comes. Right? That's all. So now we have to find the probability that neither nor. Okay, fine. So probability of sum 6 complement intersection P5 complement. Yes or no? Yes. So what is the formula again? P of A complement intersection B complement. 1 minus P of S6 union P5. Yes or no? So now using addition theorem, we can say 1 minus P of S6 plus P of P5 minus P of S6 intersection P5. Okay, fine. So total probability is 36, right? So finally, 1 minus sums, what is the probability of sum 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 things, right? So 5 by 36. Yes or no? Plus, what is the probability of getting product 5? 2. 2 by 36. Yes or no? Correct or not? So 5 by 36 and 2 by 36. Okay, fine. See friends, now we have to check whether this particular event is dependent or independent. See friends, here 1, 5 and 5, 1 are there, and 1, 5 and 5, 1 are there. Both are not disjoint. Both are dependent on each other. There is a common point is there. So the event will be like this. There is a common point, and here 5, 1 and 1, 5 is there. Yes or no? So this is a dependent event. So for this question, how many combinations are there? Only 2. 1, 5 and 5, 2. So minus 2 divided by 36. So these two gets cancelled. 1 minus 5 by 36 equals to 36 minus 5 is nothing but 31 by 36. The value is 31 by 36. Right? Hope you understand. Now let us see the fourth question. So friends, now let us see this problem. Neither sum 2 nor product 2, right? So sum 2, when sum 2 comes, whenever 1, 1, right? Sum 2, right? Only 1, 1 is the only possibility. Next, when product 2 comes, when 1, 2 and 2, 1, right? Now, what is the probability that we need? So probability of S2 complement intersection P2 complement. Yes or no? So this formula is 1 minus S2 union P2. Yes or no? So 1 minus probability of S2 plus probability of product 2 minus probability of S2 plus probability of P2 minus probability of S2 intersection P2. Yes or no? So what is 1 minus probability of sum 2 getting is only one chance is there. So 1 by 36 plus probability of product 2 getting is two chances are there. So 2 by 36 minus, see, is there any combination here? No, no common point is there. So this value becomes 0. It is nothing but, so 1 minus 3 by 36, that is nothing but 33 by 36. So 11 by, what is the probability difference? 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. 11 by 12 is the final answer. So this probability is 11 by 12. So in this way, we have to check before, when we apply addition theorem, we have to check whether the event is disjoint, whether the event is mutually exclusive, whether the event is dependent or independent. Then only we have to perform these operations. Fine? Hope you understand. This is a very logical question. Okay friends, now let us see another important question. Yeah. A card is drawn from pack of 52 cards. Find the probability that neither a diamond nor a king, neither a club nor a red, neither a 10 nor a J, neither an ace nor a face card. Okay, fine. See, this question is basing on the pack of cards. So let us just recall the pack of cards once again. So there are 52 cards. So out of 52 cards, 26 are red and 26 are black. Yes or no? Now, out of 26, there are 13 diamonds and 13 hearts. Yes? Here, 13 club and 13 spade. Yes or no? Now, see friends, listen carefully. Listen carefully. Here, every 13 consists of A's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, J, Q, K. Fine? So the first question is, what he has asked, neither a diamond nor a king. So, first of all, what is the probability of diamond, friends? How many diamonds are there? So, 13 diamonds are there. So, out of 52 cards, there are 13 diamonds. That is nothing but 1 by 4. Okay. Next, what is the probability of king? He is asking, out how many kings are there here? One king is there, one king is there, one king is there, one king. Total 4 kings are there out of 52. So, 4 by 52. That is nothing but 1 by 13. Yes or no? Yeah. Now, what is the probability that he is asking? Neither diamond nor a king. In the sense, probability of D complement intersection. Nor means intersection. Not R means intersection. Neither diamond nor king. Okay, fine. This is equal to, how can we write this? 1 minus P of D union K. Yes or no? Yes. So, this is addition theorem. 1 minus probability of diamond plus probability of the king minus probability of diamond intersection king. Right? So, yes. So, what is 1 minus P of D? Probability of diamond is 1 by 4 and probability of king is 1 by 13. Yes or no? Or else simply write 13 by 52 and 4 by 52 for the easy calculations. So, that is nothing but 13 by 52 and what is the probability of king? It's 4 by 52 minus. Is there any relation between diamond and king, friends? Yes, in diamonds there is one king. That means both are dependent events. So, king can come from diamond. Yes, there is a relation. So, how many kings can come? Only one king. So, 1 by 52. Yes or no? So, we are getting 1 minus. So, once calculate this, what we will get? 1 minus 13 plus 4, 17. 17 minus 1 is 16. So, 16 divided by 52. That is nothing but 52 minus 16 whole divided by 52. So, okay, it's 4. 4 minus 1 is 36 divided by 52. Right? 36 divided by 52 is the answer. But let us calculate. 2 1s are 2, 8s are 16. 2 2s are 4. 2 6 are 12, 2 9s are 18, 2 13s are 26. So, 9 by 13 is the probability. Fine? Yeah. So, for this question, 9 by 13 is the answer. Fine? Now, let us see neither a club nor a red. Okay, friends? See. So, fine. Now, look at the second one. Neither a club nor a red. Okay, fine. First, write the probabilities. Probability of club equals to how many clubs are there? This is the club, right? So, this is diamond. This is heart. This is club. And this is spade. Yes? So, what is the probability of club? Club, there are 13 clubs out of 52. Yes? That's nothing but 1 by 4. Okay. Now, what is the other thing he has asked? The probability of red he is asking. So, how many reds are there? There are 26 reds are there out of 52. So, 26 divided by 52, that is nothing but, how can we write? Yeah, just leave that. Just leave like this. 26 twos are 52, right? 1 by 2. Yes. So, okay. Neither a club nor a red. In the sense, probability of club complement intersection R complement. So, fine. This is nothing but 1 minus P of club union R. This is addition theorem once again. So, 1 minus P of club plus P of red minus P of club intersection red. Yes. So, 1 minus, what is P of club? 1 by 4. That is nothing but 13 by 52. Let us take for easy calculation. Next, P of red, that is nothing but 26 by 52. So, minus. What is this value, friends? Can club and red both are disjoint or independent? See, club is in black case. Here I am talking about red case. Both are disjoint event, right? So, this value becomes 0. So, until here we will calculate. So now, 1 minus, what is the value? 1 minus, yeah. 13 plus 26 in the sense, 2, 3, 39. 39 by 52, right? So, 52 minus 39 divided by 52. What is the difference between 52 and 39, friends? So 3, 1, 13. 13 by 52, that is nothing but 1 by 4. So the probability that we got is 13 by 52 or 1 by 4. So neither a club nor a red probability is 1 by 4. Okay, fine, you understand? So next one. So next one is, come on, see, neither a 10 nor a j, right? So what is the probability of 10, friends? Probability of 10 in the sense, how many 10s are there? 1 10 1 10 1 10 1 10. So total 4 10s are there out of 52. So 4 divided by 52. Yes. Next one, probability of how many j are there? 1 2 3 4. 4 j's are there. So probability of j is equal to 4 by 52. Yes. So now this is equal to 1 by 13. This is equal to 1 by 13. Yes. So neither a 10 nor j in the sense, probability of neither 10 complement intersection j complement. So that is nothing but p of 10 union j. 1 minus p of 10 plus p of j minus p of 10 intersection j. Okay, so now 1 by 13 plus p of j is 1 by 13. So this is a disjoint even, friends. This is 0 because 10 intersection j in the sense there is no relation between 10 and j. If it is 10, it is not j. If it is j, it is not 10. So both are mutually exclusive. So that value is 0. It's nothing but the finally we are going to get 1 minus 2 by 13. That is nothing but 13 minus 2 by 13. That is 11 by 13. This is the probability. So the probability is 11 by 13 here. Fine. Now let us see neither an ace nor a face card. Okay, friends, neither an ace nor a face card, right? What do you mean by a face card, friends? Face cards are nothing but J, Q, K. These three are face cards. In the entire pack of 52, how many face cards are there? Here there are J, Q, K, J, Q, K, J, Q, K, J, Q, K. There are completely 3, 3, 3, 3. There are completely 12 face cards are there, right or not? So neither an ace, how many A's are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 A's are there, right? So probability of face card is equal to 12 by 52. Because they are 12 in number, and probability of ace is equal to 4 by 52. Yes or no? Yeah. Now, so probability of neither an ace is asking. So ace complement intersection. Face card complement. So 1 minus P of ace union face card. Right? So 1 minus P of ace plus P of face card minus P of A's intersection face card. So here JQK are face cards. A's is not a face card. So A's does not belong to this face card. So this intersection is 0. These two are mutually exclusive events. Now 1 minus P of A's. What do you mean by P of A's? How much is there? 4 by 52. So 4 by 52 and plus P of face cards is 12 by 52. Right or not? Yes. So what is the value that we are going to get? 16 by 52. 1 minus 16 by 52. That's nothing but 52 minus 16 by 52. How much is that? 4 or 3. 32 by 52, right? Yes, 32 by 52 is the answer. So how can we calculate? 2 26 are 2 16s are 32. 2 8s are 16. 2 13s are 30. So 8 by 13 is the final answer. So 8 by 13 is the final answer, friends. So neither an ace nor a face card comes to 8 by 13. The probability is 8 by 13. So by using face cards also, just have this tree diagram very near to you while you are doing these sort of problems. Just when you remember this this tree diagram, it is very easy to solve any sort of question basing on 52 pack of cards. Right, friends? Got my point? So next, another important question, friends. Very interesting question. See, if A and B are two players rolling the pair of dice on the condition that one who gets the sum 7 will win the first game, will win the game. If A starts the game, okay, what are the winning chances of player A and player B? Okay, fine. So pair of dice has been rolled. Pair of dice in the sense, two dice, that is nothing but 36 total outcomes will be there for sure. 6 square is 36 outcomes. So what is the one who gets the sum 7? Sum 7 should come. So what is the probability of sum 7, friends? In the sense, so how can sum 7 comes? First of all, write the events. sum 7 in the sense 3 comma 4, 4 comma 3 and 2 comma 5, 5 comma 2, 1 comma 6 and 6 comma 1. Yes or no? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 possibilities are there. So what is the probability of sum 7, friends? In the sense, so 6 are there. So 6 by 36, that is nothing but 1 by 6. What is the probability of not getting sum 7, friends? That is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 6 is equal to 5 by 6. Yes or no? Not getting sum 6 is 5 by 6. Getting sum 6 is 1 by 6. Now, what he is asking, A is starting the game. Okay, first one who is going to roll the die is, roll that pair of die is A. So, in what is the probability of winning chances of A and winning chances of B, he is asking. When A starts the game, first of all, he will roll, right? So, there is a chance in the first attempt, he might get 7. Sum 7, then he will win the game, then B won't play again, right or not? So in the second attempt means first, if the second, in the second attempt, in the second chance, player A is going to win, in the sense is first he has to lose, then second B has to lose, and then A will win. So in the sense, see friends, probability of winning chances of A, that thing means probability of A is equal to, suppose in the first attempt itself A might win, yes, or in the second attempt A might win. In order to get the second attempt, what is the chance? First attempts A should lose, next B should lose, then A will win in the second attempt, right? Next, or in third attempt A might win. So first attempt he will lose, B also will lose, B also should lose, next A also should lose, B also should lose. Now in the third attempt A should win the game, right or not? In this way it is of infinite series. Fine. So how can I write this? Can I take W as common? 1 plus LALB plus LALB, LALB and so on. So in this way, what I will get, friends? WA is equal to 1 plus LALB plus LALB whole square. So if it is whole square, next term what is LALB whole cube, right or not? So plus and if so on. So this is nothing but the GP series, geometric progression, right? In aptitude sessions you might be seeing this in geometric progression. Some of the infinite series in GP is nothing but A by 1 minus R. Yes or no? First term by 1 minus common ratio. What is the common ratio here? LALB is the common ratio. So WA into A by, A is the first term, that is 1 by 1 minus R. R in the sense LALB. Now let us apply the probability. This is WA, friends. This is LA. LA and LB are both the same. So fine. So WA is winning chances of A is 1 by 6, right? So getting sum 7 is nothing but the winning chance. Okay. Not losing means not getting the sum. This probability. So 1 by 1 minus 5 by 6 into 5 by 6. So what you are going to get? So 1 by 6 into 1 divided by 1 minus 25 by 36. Yes or no? So to calculate this, 1 by 6 into 36 divided by 36 minus 25. Yes or no? So 6, 6 are 36 and 36 minus 25 is 11, right? So it is 6 by 11. So the probability of winning chances of A is 6 by 11. Then what is the probability of winning chances of B, friends? So probability of winning chances of B is nothing but 1 minus winning chances of A. Yes or no? Total probability is 1. 1 minus winning chances of BA in the sense 1 minus 6 by 11. So the answer is 5 by 11. So the winning chances of A, if A starts the game, is 6 by 11. And the winning chances of B is 5 by 11. Hope you understand. Got it? So next question. So next question, friends. Then these are the questions based on conditional probability. So we already know the conditional probability formula is P of A divided by B is nothing but, first of all, we need to do intersection in numerator P of A intersection B divided by P of B. Yes or no? Yeah. A die is rolled. If the number is odd, find the probability of being prime. Okay, fine. See. Yes. See, friends, carefully. What he has asked, a die is rolled once. Okay, if die is rolled, what is the sample space? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the sample space. If the number is odd, what are the odd numbers, friends? 1, 3, 5. Yes? So find the probability of getting prime. So there are 3 odd numbers. That means we have odd numbers. How many of them are prime? out of odd numbers, how many numbers will get prime? That's what he is asking. In these three odd numbers, what are prime numbers, friends? This one and this one, right? So out of three, there are two prime numbers. So 2/3 is the answer. If at all, he might also ask like probability of even by prime. In the sense, if it is prime number, what is the chances of getting an even number? In the sense, how many prime numbers are there in this year? 1, 2, 3. Yes or no? These three are prime numbers. Yes. So in these three prime numbers, how many even numbers are there? Only one. That is nothing but 1/3. If he might ask C by E, C means composite number. Right, composite numbers, what is meant by composite number? A number which is having more than two factors is nothing but a composite number. Yes or no? So listen carefully. If it is an even number, first select the even numbers. These three are even numbers. Okay, so divided by 3. What are composite numbers? 4 is the least composite number and 6 is also the composite number. So 2/3. So in this way, this is the basic question on conditional probability, friends. So let us see the another question on conditional probability. Okay. So next question, friends. A number is drawn at random from 100 numbers. He has given 100 numbers, friends, in this set from 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, so on up to 99. He has given 100 numbers for us. So a number is drawn at random, friends. One number is drawn. Let X denotes sum of the digits. X means sum of the digits, okay, on the numbers, and Y denotes product. Okay, product of the digits. Okay, fine. X means sum, Y means product. Okay, find the probability that P of X equal to 9 by Y equal to 0. Okay, fine. See, what he has asked exactly? Probability of X equals to 9 divided by Y equals to 0. In the sense, A by B, right? So, don't get confused. Means, probability of sum equals to 9 divided by product equal to 0. When product becomes 0, what is the probability that sum becomes 9? That's what he is asking. So what, same probability of A by B is nothing but P of A intersection B by P of B. In the sense, probability of X equal to 9 intersection Y equals to 0 divided by P of Y equals to 0. Yes or no? So now, so we have to find the probabilities of these two. So what he has given from 0, 0 to 99, right? So P of Y equal to 0. When product will become 0, friends? For what combinations product will become 0 from these 100 numbers? So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 8, and 0, 9. Okay. 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 8, 0, and 90. Only for these combinations, friends, Y becomes 0. So these are the total outcomes. So how many are there? 9 and 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 are there. Yes or no? So out of 19, how many we need now? So in these 19, X equal to 9, sum should become 9 and product should become 0. What are these ones? 0 plus 9 is 9, right? 9 plus 0 is also 9, right? Remaining no number, no digits will get us the sum 9, right? These two only are getting. So favorable outcomes is 2. So the answer is 2/19. In this way, we will approach this question, friends. Such a beautiful question. Don't get confused by giving equal to here. He is nothing. He is also defined. Previously, he is defining what X is and what Y is. In that way, you need to understand. Okay. So I think I hope you understand the answer, right? Next one. Okay, friends, now this is a very, very interesting question. These type of questions we need to study very carefully in order to understand, in order to do the problem. So let us read the question once. 60% of the employees of a company are college graduates. Okay, 60% are college graduates. Of these, in this 60%, 10% are in sales. Okay, fine. In this 60%, 10% are in sales department. Of the employees who did not graduate from the college are 80% in the sales department. Who did not graduate are 80% in the sales department. A person is selected at random. Find the probability that person is in sales. Okay, fine. We have to find the probability that a person is in sales. That means probability of a person in sales. Okay, fine. We need to find this. Before that, we have to write the given data. See, friends, what he has asked, what he has given, 60% of the employees are college graduates. That means probability of graduates is nothing but 60%. 60% in the sense 0.6. Probability of non-graduates equal to 0.4, right? 1 minus 0.6 is 0.4. Yes or no? So P of A complement is 1 minus P of A. So 1 minus 0.6 in the sense 0.4. Okay, fine. Now, what he has given in another case, next, of these 10% are in sales department. 10% are in sales department in the sense, what do you mean by it? So, they are graduates and in sales department. So, they are graduates and they are in sales department. So, this is what he has given, P of S by G. What is P of S by G? That is nothing but 10%, which is nothing but 0.1. And another thing what he has given, of the employees who did not graduate from the college are 80% from the sales department. Who did not graduate in the sense? Who did not graduate also they are in sales department. That means the probability of non-graduates in the sales department is equal to 80%. That is nothing but 0.8. Yes or no? So now what he is asking, a person is selected at random, okay, find the probability that person is in sales. That means P of S is asking. So in the sales department, there are only two graduates, friends. One is two workers, right? One worker will be a graduated worker, another will be non-graduated worker. In the sales department, only two types of workers are working. So fine. So we can get a worker, we can get a person such a way that either graduate or in the sense plus, right? Or we can get a non-graduate candidate. Yes or no? If a person is selected from sales, definitely he might be graduated or non-graduated person. Yes or no? So according to this, this is a conditional probability. We can apply P of G into P of S by G plus P of G complement into P of S by G complement. Yes or no? So what is P of G, friends? 0.6 into P of S by G is nothing but 0.1. Yes or no? Plus, what is P of G complement? It's 0.4 into, what is P of S by G complement? It's 0.8. 6 by 10 into 1 by 10 plus 4 by 10 into 8 by 10. So, how can we get? So, 6 by 100 next plus 32 by 100, that is nothing but 38 by 100, which is equal to 0.38. This is the final answer. So 0.38 means 38%. We have the probability of getting a person who is in sales. Fine. So this is the way to approach. This is called theorem of total probability. Now let us see a problem on Bayes theorem. Okay, fine. So this is a beautiful question, friends. GATE 2012 question. See, an automobile plant contracted to buy shock absorbers from two suppliers X and Y. Okay, fine. There are two suppliers X and Y. They are producing shock absorbers, the instruments which provides the shock, which absorbs the shock. Okay. X is a company which supplies 60% of the observers and Y supplies 40% of the shock absorbers. Okay, fine. That is the one of the given data. And all shock observers are subjected to a quality test. Every shock observer is subject to a quality test, friends. A test was made. The ones that pass the quality test are considerable reliable. One who qualifies in that test only is said to be reliable. One which works very well. Okay, fine. Next one, of X shock observers, 96% are reliable. Those which are made from X are 96% are reliable. Of Y shock observers, 72% are reliable. From Y which are made, 72% are reliable. The probability of the randomly chosen shock observer which is found to be reliable, which is made by Y, is C. Fine. Let us write the given data, friends, first. What is the probability of X? Nothing but he has given 60% means 0.6, right? Yes. Probability of X is 0.6. Next, probability of Y supplies is 40%. So, P of Y is equal to 0.4. Yes or no? Next, all the shock observers are subjected to a quality test. Fine. The ones that pass the quality test are considered reliable. Okay, fine. Of X shock observers, 96% are reliable. Okay, fine. Now, let us understand. From shock observers X, how many are reliable? From X shock observers, the number of probability of reliability is how many, friends? Where is it? For all the shock observers pass the quality test are considered 96%. That is nothing but 0.96. Next, of the shock observers which are reliable, E is equal to 72%, right? That is nothing but 0.72. Now, what he is asking us? He is asking probability of randomly chosen shock observer which is found reliable. It should be reliable and made by Y. Okay, fine. We should it is found reliable. So this is the first condition. This is the known condition is reliable and unknown condition is y. Okay, fine. So fine, what is asking in the sense that should be reliable and it should be from y. Yes or no? Is this the thing he is asking? So what is the formula, friends? P of y intersection r divided by p of r. Yes or not? So what is p of y intersection r? P of y into p of r by y. Yes or no? So this will become p of y into p of r by y. Yes, whole divided by what is p of r, friends? Probability of reliability. Reliability is there in x and reliability is also there in y. So reliability is there in x and reliability is also there in y. So p of x into x reliability plus p of y reliability. Yes or no? Yes or not? Yes. Now, how can I write this? P of y into P of r by y. This is nothing but Bayes' theorem only, friends. P of r by y whole divided by P of x into P of r by x using conditional probability plus P of y into P of r by y. Yes or no? So this is the thing. So now we can apply the given data values in that equations. Now what we are going to get? So finally we are going to get the value as what is p of y here? 0.4. 0.4 into what is p of r by y? P of r by y is nothing but 0.72 into and whole divided by p of x. What is the value of p of x, friends? 0.6. 0.6 into what is p of r by x? 0.96 plus and what is p of y? It's 0.4 and what is p of r by y? It's nothing but 0.72. by substituting this you will be getting the value as I think it is 0.334. this is the final answer. So 33.4% will be the reliable from manufacturing of made by y. Okay, friends. So this is the process you need to understand in Bayes' theorem. Okay. So now, friends, another important question. This question is also basing on Bayes' theorem only. Listen carefully. In a college, 4% of the men and 1% of the women are taller than 1.8 meters. So 4% of the men and 1% of the women are taller than 1.8 meters. Okay, fine. Furthermore, he has also given an extra additional data. 60% of the students are women. 60% are women. That means probability of being a woman is nothing but 60% in the sense 60 by 100, right? That is nothing but 0.6. In the sense, just keep it as 60 by 100 only so that the calculations will be easier. In the previous problem also, just keep like this only. Fine. So now, what is the probability of being a man, friends? Nothing but 40 by 100, right? So if women are 60, definitely men will be 40, right? In percentage. Now, if it's next, what he has given, taller than 1.8 meters is from when 4% are there. So men who are taller are nothing but how many men who are taller than nothing but how many, my friends? No, men who are taller. So taller from men, right? So yeah, men, we have men. In that when how much the probability of being tall is 4%, that is nothing but 4 by 100, and probability of being a woman and they are taller is 1%, that is 1 by 100. Yes, this is the given data. One, what he has asked, he has selected a student is selected at random and the student is noted to be taller than 1.8 meters. Find the probability that the student is being a woman. Okay, fine. Now what is the known event here? The student is tall and that student should be one. What is the probability? Fine. See, look at that. See, P of A by B is nothing but P of A into P of B, P of A intersection B by P of B, right? So P of W intersection T divided by P of T. So now how can I write this? P of W into P of T by W. Yes or no? Now, what is P of T, friends? P of probability of being a taller student is both in case of men and women. So either from women he can be tall or from men he can be the person can be taller. Yes, so this can be written as P of W into P of T by W whole divided by, this is also P of W into P of T by W. This is Bayes' theorem. This is the total probability. This denominator is called theorem of total probability. And now this is converting into Bayes' theorem. See friends, P of M into P of T by M. Yes. Now, we have all the given data. So, what is P of W friends? 60 by 100. 60 by 100 into, what is P of T by W? This is nothing but 1 by 100. Whole divided by, what is P of W again? 60 by 100 into P of T by W is 1 by 100 plus, what is P of M? Is 40 by 100 into, what is P of T by M? Is 4 by 100. Is nothing but 60 whole divided by 10,000 whole divided by 60 into 160, 60 plus 4 is 16, 160, 160 plus 60 is 220. So 220, right? 4 is 16, 160, 160 plus 60 is 220. Yes, 220 divided by, this is once again 10,000. These two gets cancelled, this 0 gets cancelled. 6 by 22 we got, 6 by 22 in the sense 2 3s are 6, 2 1s are 2, 11, 2 11s are 22. So answer is 3 by 11. So in this case, we approach Bayes' theorem. So Bayes' theorem is very simple friends. Only the thing is you need to understand is obtaining the data and applying in the formula. That's all. That is what Bayes' theorem is. Fine. So now we have finished the main important concepts regarding probability. We have seen the conditional probability, basics in the probability, conditional probability, and also the total probability and Bayes' theorem. We have seen everything. Now we will be going for random variables. Fine.